Star Investments Limited. It's got your name on it.
Thank you, Chair. So this application, which you'll probably recall, came before you in 2022 in October. For the application as listed on the screen above, which is up to 578 residential units and up to 3,000 flexible e-space, commercial e-space. It's a hybrid application, so in effect, part of it is in detail and part is outline, with the detailed elements being blocks A and C, one, the rest being in outline. So the application, say, came before you in October 2020. That was resolved to approve, subject to the signing of the Section 106 agreement. The clause on the recommendation that you considered was that the Section 106 agreement be signed within 3 months of that committee date. Now, that hasn't taken place. We are beyond that. The Section 106 has now been signed in accordance with the matters that were listed in the previous report, and I've included the previous report and the updates to those as appendices to your papers. That's now been signed. But before officers are in a position to issue a decision, the matter's being returned to the committee for determination purely because we're outside of that 3 month period that you made your recommendation on. So, as I say, I've appended the paperwork from the committee meetings to your papers. Obviously, as the application is undetermined at this stage, all the matters considered within there, including the objections, obviously pertinent to your decision today, and just also draw your attention to the update sheet. We've had a few additional identical objections following the publication of the papers that do not necessarily raise material planning considerations per se, but do draw reference to their previous objections that are listed in the report. So let me just give you a very brief synopsis of the scheme just to refresh your minds, just so it's for completeness. So that was the resolution that went to committee before. So there's no changes to the scheme. So the scheme in terms of the details before you is not altered from when you discussed it at the previous committee in 2022. There's no changes to local plan policy, but there has been some changes to the MPPF. There's been two iterations since you last heard it, and I'm sure there'll be another one just around the corner. But I think having looked at the changes to the MPPF, that probably does nothing but actually enhance support for the scheme with the continuing growth and agenda for developing brownfield sites, bringing forward housing in sustainable locations. So that's your site location plan edged in red. And you can see where you are in relation to where we're sitting now, just due north. So this is a context plan to just show the site in context of surroundings. And just a more detailed picture of the site with some photographs. So this is a layout plan. So I don't know if my screen will... So this is block A in this location, and this is block C1. So these are the detailed elements, and I've got some imagery of that. The rest are all indicative and outlined to come forward as a separate reserve matters or a series of reserve matters applications in due course. So this is a context plan showing the maximum building heights. Okay, so building A, you can see just from the plan here, it's this building here. So these are the elevations of the building, and these are some CGI imagery of what the building would look like once constructed. Turning to building C1, similar in its design, so there's obviously that seamless approach taken to the design as a site, so it's kind of comprehensive, and again some imagery of the building once built. These are the elevations of the site from east through to west, north through to south, and just some illustrative views. So the key issues, members, are listed in your report. Officers believe that this is a very significant application that we're looking for and will obviously be a catalyst for further development in town centre and also bring significant visual enhancement. to this part of the town centre. It's a significant number of new homes in a very sustainable location, as well as flexible, approximately 3,000 square metres of flexible e-class use, again in a town centre, therefore bringing in trade, money, visitors, etc. into the town centre. As I said, there's been no changes to the scheme. It remains acceptable having due regard to local plan policy and the MPPF, and it's pleasing that section 106 is signed, and hopefully with the issue of an imminent decision that works can start on site, and also the rest of the schemes can come forward as reserved matters, and we can get that going as well. So the recommendation, Chair, is to approve subject to the conditions as listed in your report. Thank you, Chair.
Thank you, Elizabeth. I've got one speaker, which is Councillor Tony Evans.
Doesn't the developer speak first?
Sorry?
Doesn't the developer speak first? Or they...
I've got one speaker just for yourself.
Right, sorry. Just to remind the committee, Strawberry Star bought the property bought this area way back in November 18. So it's at least 5.5 years, if not longer, since they, and they bought it with planning permission. And then in November 22, we had the announcement of some property being knocked down, and we were all being told at that time that it was going to be dealt with, starting on the property, etc., and went over forward. In fact, what we've seen from Strawberry Star over the last few years is we've seen deterioration of properties. They failed to maintain the properties that have been left standing. There's been a build-up of rubbish. We've had rat infestations on the time, and the site has been appallingly badly managed. We then go forward to, we're now being asked to, you're being asked rather to be given further planning permission. Although, yes, we would hope that work is going to start on the properties relatively soon. However, in a statement to your Harlow, Strawberry Star stated, thank you for reaching out on the government with the construction project. We appreciate your concern. We'd like to assure you we're committed to commencing the project as soon as practically possible. However, it's important to acknowledge that the construction industry is currently facing significant challenges resulting in delays across the country, in which case they're giving absolutely no idea as to when the work is going to start on the property. So therefore, what I would like to ask you as a planning committee to consider is whether or not there is any way in terms of the requirements with regard to this planning, with regard to granting this planning application, you could put in provisions for the maintenance of the site in the interim. But this could go on for years. And are we saying that it's acceptable that Strawberry Star be allowed to continue in the way that they are at the moment with regard to the management of that site?
Thank you, Councillor. Any questions for the officers? Councillor.
Thank you, Chair. Now that this has been signed, has Strawberry Star said when they are going to be start building this? Because as Councillor Edwards has said, it's been going on for too many years and it's just getting worse and worse.
In short, no, we can't ask that question. Obviously, they're bound by time limits on their planning conditions. So in terms of detailed element, that's they would be required to make a commencement of development within 3 years. And there's separate time limits for the submission of reserve matters for the outstanding elements of the scheme. But we don't have any powers through planning to actually insist they start any sooner than that. We are just bound by those conditions on the commission.
Thank you. Sorry.
Hold it. Thank you. Just to add to that, we haven't got the decision notice yet. If you go with the recommendation tonight on other decision notice, then they will be able to start work before they could, because they didn't have the decision notice. So it would that point of view, I'm technically commence now.
Councillor.
Thank you, Chair. I think Councillor has raised a relevant point, and I don't know if this can be made a condition, if it's possible. Regarding the maintenance of the site, because we've had rat infestations, that is a fact, and that's a health issue which should concern everybody. Is that possible to put that in as a condition?
Unfortunately not. We can't put that down as a condition, but if there are issues in terms of that site, then there's separate powers through the environmental health team or through potentially through planning enforcement and the untidy sites to take action, but it can't be done through a condition on the planning permission.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Chair. I just look at a technical detail. The actual application has received planning approval, and there was a condition of that section 106 with a certain period. We've got past that. It has now been summoned. From what you were saying just now, it sounds as though the actual technical legal process of the planning approval won't be approved until, say, tonight or tomorrow. So therefore, that's where the clock will start ticking on 3 years and so forth. Is that right?
Yeah, so it hasn't got planning approval yet. It doesn't get planning approval until we issue a decision notice. And we've not been able to issue a decision notice until all parties have signed up to the Section 106 agreement. So that's why this application is here with you now. If members are minded to support the application, then we can issue that decision notice without any delay, and then the clock starts ticking in terms of those timescales.
Councillor Morrison.
Thank you. Affordable housing, again. If I read the papers correctly, quite a lot of papers. Inevitably, there won't be any affordable housing with this particular development. If I understood that correctly, but it would be great, absolutely brilliant, if you could say, no, you're wrong, there will be, there definitely will be some. The word unavoidable is used in the papers. In other words, unavoidable. It is unavoidable that there will be none, if you know what I mean. So does that mean that there is no mechanism that we have built in or could build in any sort of a review as with the previous application?
Firstly, apologies for the amount of paperwork, but you had to have sight of all that previous history in one place to actually make sure you had all that information for you. Again, similar to which our viability is an issue with the site, and the independent report has come back saying it isn't viable to provide affordable housing, but there is an early stage review mechanism and a late stage review mechanism included within the Section 106 agreement that has been signed up to. So if miraculously the market does improve and everything else, there is a mechanism for us to then secure some of that back.
So if we sign this off tonight here, then you can do your part. The 3 years starts.
Yes.
So when are we going to get an indicator within that 3 years? And then you might put your answer is that they're actually going to do it. So if we get to the stage where we're 3 years in and nothing's happened, where do we go then?
So yeah, the 3 years starts from the date we issue a decision notice, so potentially say tomorrow or Friday, what, Thursday, what, it's not Wednesday, is it? In short, I say we have regular discussions with the representatives of the applicant, and we have those discussions, so hopefully we can gain some insight and information on that, but there's also the process that they will need to discharge pre-commencement conditions. And there, as you can see from the papers, there's a number of those that require discharging. So again, it's the sooner they start those works to get those discharged, and obviously the sooner they can start development of the site. But it very much down to down to the applicant as to when they start that work. Now, we're also hopeful they will do that quickly.
Yeah.
That's what everybody hopes, because it is such a big scheme, and obviously visually it's very important.
Yeah.
But we have those discussions, you know, they understand the view of members in terms of the need for this, and hopefully they can take that away and move that forward.
Because we have been here before in other years, and it's not happened.
And ultimately,
so it's quite frustrating to think we're going to do it again. We're going to, in good faith, as a council, we're going to sign this all off, but we can't guarantee that this will actually be picked up by this developer, as it hasn't been by previous.
And that's planning, isn't it, ultimately?
Yeah.
We can go on permission, sometimes permissions lapse, sometimes they're sold to other parties,
yeah,
and they come in with revised plans. All we can do is make a decision based on the information that's submitted to us.
Yeah.
And beyond that, there are different discussions applicants have about it.
Yeah.
Questions? Can I ask Julie a question? If members decide to refuse the application, are we exposed to various legal proceedings?
Thank you, Chair. Thank you for your question, Chair. If members are wanted to refuse this application, the usual requirement to have strong reasons for refusal at this meeting is to be noted, and we will take it from there.
Okay, thank you very much indeed.
So page 165 of your paperwork,
yeah.
Condition 17. So that was the working hours, I suppose, for 7 to 6 weekdays and 8 till 1 Saturdays. Now that is the hours that were put towards the committee back in October that you as a committee found acceptable. And it's obviously within your gift if you want to change it, but let's say that they were the hours that were put to committee before, so that basically I've just appended that report,
yes,
back to the committee. So,
Chair, would you be happy if I were to propose that we make it our usual working day rather than earlier? At the moment it says from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Oh, I see. Yep.
Yes.
7 o'clock in the morning till 8 at 6 o'clock at night.
Yes.
And then 8 till 1 on Saturdays.
I wasn't here, councillor, when the application was recommended for approval by committee before. The other thing I would say, that the usual reason for the hours being put on the construction is so not to impact on local residents, and there are no local residents. So, you know, just to bear in mind, if you're not actually conveniencing anybody, then it's obviously, if you want this to happen quickly, the longer they're able to actually work and deliver the development, the better. So I know there are usual hours, but they are usually around residents' amenity. And if there aren't any residents for amenity to be damaged, then perhaps, you know, we should have longer hours. But obviously it's a matter for the committee. But.
I'm not minded to agree with Pauline there to second that, but I know members want to.
No, I think working out as fine as they are.
It's not to you.
Absolutely.
She's got points.
So there's no support for that change.
I'm very disappointed.
Right, discussions. I'll just talk, put my Pennyworth in if you like. We actually here, we need to decide what the benefits are to agree this tonight, or what's the downside if we don't agree it tonight. We're not here to decide whether the Strawberry Star is a good company or bad company, or got, you know, whether they're going to build this or not. That's history will tell us that at a later stage. But I think the way I look at it, the benefits by approving this is at least we've put the elephant out of the room, if you like. I don't know why they didn't sign the 106. Whether it's because they had problems, but that's up to them. It's not for us to decide on that basis. So, you know, on that, that's why I'm in favour of granting it. You know, anybody else got some remarks?
Just members, setting aside the particular applicant, planning permission goes with the land. So, you know, who's to say it will always be this applicant? But I get members' frustration. This is a key town centre site. It's very, very important for the economic development and regeneration of Harlow, which is dear to all our hearts. So to have a positive planning permission on that key town centre site, I would suggest to you, it's entirely a matter for you, it's much more beneficial to Harlow moving forward. Now, we looked at the very, very detailed report. I mean, I know maybe some all members were on the committee at the time, but the planning committee, not too far distant far, assessed the committee, looked at all the issues, and agreed that subject to the conditions, you were happy with the proposal. So, you know, assuming you're still happy for the proposal to go ahead and you want the site to be regenerated, I would suggest the most positive thing for the regeneration of the town is through the application. But obviously it's a matter for you, but just, you know, bear that in mind moving forward. The planning permission goes with the land. It's much more positive it's got a permission than it doesn't. Thanks, Jim.
I agree there as well. You know, there's more benefits by agree this tonight than trying to turn it down. Who knows where we're going to turn it down, you know. Councillor.
Thank you. This is sounding a bit like an echo chamber on that one. Let's see, well, you know, the applicant is irrelevant to this. What is it? We have a master plan for the town centre. We want the town centre to be regenerated. Unless there's planning permission on this site, nobody's going to redevelop it. So that is the convincing argument as to why we should support this application.
Any more discussions? Councillor Steer.
Thank you, Chair. To my memory, I don't think I was on the planning committee when this originally came up. And it's not much about the scheme I personally like, but I am mindful of what you're saying about the land having to have planning permission on it, regardless of who actually builds the scheme. So with great reluctance, I will support the application. I think this particular scheme that we're looking at is a pretty dreadful one, particularly when we take it in account of what we were looking at earlier with other regeneration schemes in the town centre, which are definitely going to happen. And this is totally unsympathetic to them, but as I say, it is important the land has planning permission, so I do support it.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor Morrison.
Yeah, briefly, I wasn't part of the planning at that time either. I was elsewhere. however, that doesn't prevent my understanding the need for regeneration. There's an urgency, in fact. There has already been delay, a lot of disappointments. I'm not the only one being disappointed, it would seem. And so I'm not sure that we have an alternative. We really don't have much choice this evening but to support the application.
Thank you, Councillor. Councillor
Halker? I would have been on the planning committee when this started way back, but I agree that for the land angle, we need to take this towards a good end for the people of the town.
Thank you. Any more comments? No? We'll go to the recommendation, which is on page 68, there it is.
The recommendation 71.
So, planning permission to grant planning permission. All those in favour? Unanimous?